The Chief Justice and the other judges have been hiding inside Malay's Supreme Court after being threatened with arrest, and they had appealed to India. But what is India expected to do? Can Delhi pull off a repeat of its previous interventions? Let's take a look. In 1988, there was an attempted coup by Maldivian businessmen aiming to overthrow the then president, Mamoon Gayoom. And they got help from outside, from armed Tamil rebels, from neighbouring Sri Lankan President Gayoom called out to India for help. And New Delhi, and then under Prime Minister Rajiv Gandhi, he sent 1,600 Indian troops there for Operation Cactus, saw the Indian army arrive there within 12 hours and crush the attempted coup. All 19 Tamil militants who had taken over the Malay airport were killed and one Indian soldier was injured. India had helped Malay in other crises too. The next occasion was in 2014. The capital Malay's water treatment plant had broken down. This time, India flew heavy transporters like the C-17 Globemaster, which was carrying bottled water. New Delhi also sent Indian naval ships with water dispensation plants on board to produce fresh water for Malay. Then in 2015, the country's first democratically elected president, Mohammad Nasheed, was arrested on trumped-up charges, but he could leave the country on medical grounds and has since lived in exile. Maldives President Abdullah Yameen has been continuously stifling the democracy through his move after move, and unsurprisingly, India has turned a cold shoulder. The Maldives is the only country which Prime Minister Modi has not visited in the region. The latest judgment restores Mr. Nasheed's credibility and the release of 12 other members of Maldivian Democratic Party now makes it single largest party in Malay's Majlis or Parliament. But the country's judges have reportedly received death threats. They have issued a fervent appeal to India to help. Will India play a traditionally cautious game of wait and watch? Or will it ignore China's growing presence across South Asia and finally reclaim the ocean it lends its name to by responding to the crisis? For now, New Delhi says it's monitoring the developments closely.